Six blind men encountered an elephant for the first time. One of them felt the trunk of the elephant and said, "This creature is like a snake." Another felt the ear and said, "No, it is like a fan." The third felt the leg and said, "It is like a tree." The fourth, feeling the tail, thought it was like a rope. The fifth, touching the tusk, concluded it was like a spear. And the sixth, resting against the body, was convinced that it was like a wall. Many have used this story to explain why there are different world religions. The point being that different people have experienced certain aspects of divine truth and have assumed that their experience tells the whole story. But what if? What if the elephant could talk?
Hey guys, you have all come up with interesting theories about me. Theories which are partly correct, but mostly incorrect. Now let me tell you about myself.
The problem with the parable of the blind men and the elephant is that it assumes that the divine reality is silent, and that the best humans can do is grope in the dark to discover some small aspect of that reality. The Christian worldview is very different. In times past, God spoke in partial and various ways to our ancestors through the prophets. In these last days, He spoke to us through a Son, whom He made heir of all things and through whom He created the universe. Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever walks with me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." Jesus claimed to reveal the truth about God, that He created us and loved us and wants us to be saved from our sins. When someone comes to Jesus in faith, He takes away his blindness and gives him spiritual sight. Jesus did not portray Himself as a mere messenger or teacher of some truths. Rather, He declared Himself to be the way, the truth, and the life. Many people identify themselves as Christians, but have not really taken the time to learn about Jesus and the church He established. They are content to let their faith occupy a small compartment in their life. Such an approach is completely inconsistent with the extraordinary claims made by Jesus. C.S. Lewis wrote, "Christianity, if false, is of no importance, and if true, of infinite importance. The only thing it cannot be is moderately important." Are you content with groping in the dark for partial truths? Or do you want to hear what the elephant has to say about himself?